This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes the nature of transfer pricing and how best to determine what transfer price to use between divisions within the same company. So what is a transfer price? It's the price that's used to value the transfer of goods or services, as I mentioned, between divisions within the same company. And we often use the term subunits or segments to describe divisions. Many approaches can be used to establish a transfer price, and we're going to talk about a few of those here. But the goal is to establish a transfer price that encourages managers to do really two things: what's in the best interest of the company, and also what's in the best interest of the division. And there can often be a conflict between the two, so the goal then is to establish a transfer price that avoids that conflict. The general economic pricing rule provides us with some guidelines that we can use to establish transfer pricing between divisions that will not only help the divisions, but also maximize the overall company profit. So the rule states, it's kind of a technical description here, and we'll get into an example on the next slide, but the rule states that the transfer price should be set at a differential cost to the differential cost to the selling division plus the opportunity cost of making the sale internally. So instead of dwelling on that here, let me give you a couple of examples on the next two slides, and I think you'll see how this falls into place. So here's an example of applying the general economic pricing rule when we are below capacity, when the selling division is below capacity. On the next slide, we'll talk about what happens when the selling division is at capacity. But right now, we'll talk about when the selling division is below capacity. In this example, let's assume that we are Umbrellas Inc., so we make umbrellas, and we have two divisions. We have the assembly division, that's basically the production department, and we have the marketing division. And so the assembly department is the selling division, and in this example, and the marketing department will be the buying division. Umbrellas Inc. is currently operating below capacity. So we have plenty of excess capacity. We're selling to the outside, but we're also selling to a division internally. And when we sell internally, we're not giving up any sales on the outside. So that means that we are below capacity. We have plenty of excess capacity. Our variable production costs are $6 per unit. That's in the assembly department for all the parts and materials that go into the umbrella those variable production costs. That cost is about $6 per unit. Our marketing department sometimes purchases umbrellas from the assembly department. So the assembly department's the selling department, and the marketing department or division is the buying department. The transfer price then is calculated as follows using the general economic pricing rule, and that is, it's the differential cost to the selling division, which is $6. So if I'm the selling division, it costs me $6 for each umbrella that I produce. So that is my differential cost at $6. And add to that the opportunity cost of selling internally. That is there any cost for us selling internally rather than selling to the outside? And when we're below capacity, the answer is no. There is no opportunity cost. As I mentioned before, we're not foregoing any outside sales to sell internally. Therefore, the transfer price is $6. It's really the differential cost. Since there's no opportunity cost, it's the differential cost to the selling division, to the assembly division. And therefore, the transfer price should be $6. That's the price that the optimum price that the assembly department should charge the marketing department when the assembly department sells to the marketing department. Now we'll take a look at what happens when we're at capacity. So really, all of the facts from the previous case are the same with one exception, and that is that if we sell internally, then we are foregoing sales to the outside. So again, we got two divisions, same two divisions, assembly and marketing, and we are now operating, as I mentioned, at capacity. The variable production costs are the same for each umbrella that we produce. The cost for us is $6 per unit. And again, the marketing buys on occasion umbrellas from the assembly department. And the assembly department then is the selling department. And the transfer price is going to be a bit different. We're going to calculate the transfer price here at the bottom. Same general economic pricing rule, but we're going to have some additional information here. The transfer price is going to be equal to the differential cost to the selling division, which is still $6 per unit. And then we add to that, as you recall from the previous slide, the opportunity cost of selling internally. And we do have an opportunity cost in this example because for every unit we sell internally, that's one less unit that we sell to companies on the outside. So every time we sell internally, we are foregoing $4 per unit. And if you look down below at the footnote, you'll see where that comes from. We typically sell our umbrellas to the outside for $10. I'm just simply giving you this information. And our variable cost, as you recall, is $6. So we're foregoing $4 in revenue by selling internally because we are at capacity. So the transfer price should be the differential cost of $6 plus the $4 opportunity cost. And therefore, the transfer price in this example is $10 per unit. And that's how much the assembly department should charge the marketing department when selling umbrellas to the marketing department because we are at capacity. So the transfer price, when we're at capacity in this example, is $10 per unit.